Hari Hari Biphale. Hari Hari Biphale, Janam Agwai. Hari Hari Biphale Janam Agwai.
Thank you.
spent my life uselessly, having obtained a human birth and having not worshipped Radha and Krishna, I have knowingly drunk poison. Therefore, I am lamenting. Human life is meant for worshipping Radha and Krishna. It is a rare opportunity to get a human body, and it is a chance for the initial souls to get out of the material world, which is a place of suffering. But when we don't, if we don't do that, then Narottam says this is like drinking poison, knowing they're committing suicide. Spiritual suicide means to forget oneself, the spirit. So we are in a state of forgetfulness. We think we are this body. We forget that we are spirit soul. Or we have no knowledge. Pretty much in Kali Yuga, everyone is like this. So, therefore, we are drinking poison knowingly. It says the treasure of divine love in Goloka Vrindavan has descended. Goloka of Prema Dhan. Dhan means treasure or wealth. So it's coming from Goloka. It has descended as the congregational chanting of the Lord's holy names. Such a nice thing. Imported from the spiritual world. So Narottam says, it's so nice coming from Goloka Vrindavan, but why did my attraction for this chanting never come about? Day and night, my heart burns from the fire of the poison of material life, worldliness. And although I'm suffering, I have not taken the means to relieve it. I'm burning up, burning inside. But people are walking around thinking that they're so cool. They're suffering. So. And he tells us that Vrajendranandan Krishna, he's come as Sachinanda, the Lord Chaitanya, the son of Mother Sachi. And Balaram, his elder brother, has come as Nithai. They were distributing this holy name to everyone. Anyone and everyone. And he didn't care who was qualified or unqualified. The evidence of this was Jagai and Madai. They were certainly the lowest at the time. But Lord Nityananda Prabhu, they didn't stop him. In fact, he was chased by them, him and Haridas Thakur. They were chased, they had to run for their lives from these two fellows. Nityananda came back. still determined to give them the holy name. So. Srila Prabhupada, when he was told by his Guru Maharaj, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, to take this to the Western world. He wanted this to happen. He wanted it to happen because Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted it to happen. Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted it to happen because Lord Chaitanya wanted it to happen. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came with his, as we sang in the other song, Sharanagati, that he came with his personal associates, his abode, his town, to teach Sharanagati. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, he didn't come just to deliver the people of India. He wanted to deliver everyone. So Prabhupada understood this. And he took the instructions of Bhaktisiddhanta to heart. It means he made it his life and soul, his life's mission. And he came. Great difficulty, and practically no support. In fact, people tried to discourage him from coming. They thought, people in the West are too far gone, hopeless cases. Prabhupada said in Los Angeles, he said, I knew my task was difficult because I was coming to teach cow protection to the cow killers. And I thought, as soon as I tell them, but you know, I tell them about Sharanagati, they would say, Swami, please go home. Yes, but still he persevered, and now the Krishna consciousness movement is flourishing so many years after Prabhupada is gone. And as long as we follow the principles of Sharanagati, it will keep on growing, because it is the desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So when Narottam Das Thakur, the Acharya, is praying to Lord Krishna, son of Nanda Maharaj, accompanied by the daughter of Maharaj, Vrishabhanu, Radha, says, please be merciful to me now. Don't push me away from your reddish lotus feet. Who is my beloved except for you?